What's good, guys? So today we're gonna do a music video breakdown on Chris Will's Love No More video. If you guys have not seen the music video, feel free to just check it out. I'll leave a link somewhere up here so you guys can check it out. If not, it's the last video I posted. So really just wanna break it down, talk about lighting and the audio. A lot of you guys talked about, you guys really like the sound of that audio, so really wanna break that down as well. So let's just get started on the breakdown. Alright, so before we even get started on the Chris Will Love No More music video breakdown, let's start off with the camera gear that I use, which, you know, a lot of you guys always question. So for this particular video, it was the last video I actually shot with the Panasonic S1H. So the S1H camera was a camera that I used for this music video. The lens that I used for this music video was a Sigma 24mm 1.4 art lens and the Sigma 50mm 1.4 art lens as well. So those are the only two lenses that I used throughout this music video. And the gimbal that I used was a DJI RS2. And I think that's pretty much as far as that gear. So let's just jump straight into the video. Let's talk about the first thing, the way the video starts off. And that is, there was a dialogue. It wasn't planned, it was kind of like in the moment. So I got a bunch of different shots in order to basically, you know, compensate for the miscommunication, or they're always gonna switch up different words, in order for me to kind of cut it and try to make it as fluid as possible. So I got multiple angles. The audio that I used, the recorder that I basically put on the artist and the girl, the model, it was a Tascam DR10. Everything I talk about will be linked in the description below in case you guys are interested. But the audio is really crisp. It was right on her. I think it was in between her bra inside. And then also for the artist, we had it like basically coming out right here. And that allowed us to get that crispy quality audio.
What's up, babe?
Don't even touch me.
What are you tripping for? What's wrong?
What's wrong?
Yeah.
You never had time for me.
Obviously, we did do some tweaking on the audio in order to enhance it and make it sound a lot better. But just in case you guys were wondering, it was a Tascam DR10. And a quick little tip, when you guys are shooting dialogue and nothing's planned, get as much angles and redo it over and over and over again. I think we did this probably like 10 times. Because I knew that no words were ever gonna be the same. So I just wanted to make sure it was a fluid cut. So I got shots of him, shots of her, wide shots, another wide shot, a different shot. Not everything obviously made it to the video because you don't wanna throw it off with so many angles, but I wanted to keep it as fluid as possible. So you guys shoot dialogue and there's nothing planned, I recommend for you guys to just really just grab a lot of shots. Now, before I move on with the video, I do wanna talk about how I shot this video as far as picture profile, because a lot of people always ask me. And anything you guys watch in my videos going forward, everything is shot either in S-Log 3 now with the Sony, or the S1H was in V-Log. I shoot everything in log just to get the best dynamic range and the best colors for my videos. So just in case you guys are wondering, for this particular music video, it was in V-Log, 4K 24 10-bit, and also 4K 60 10-bit. Just in case you guys were wondering on how I achieved this. All right, so now we're gonna jump into the beginning portion of the music video. Dialogue is out of the way. So now it's the actual start of the music video. And obviously for this one, it's very story driven, and she kicked him out within the dialogue. Like basically he left and it was like a miscommunication on their part, right? Like she's not happy anymore basically. So I wanted to get an outdoor shot where he's leaving the city. What I wanted was to expose him clearly. That was the first thing. I was not just gonna bump the ISO, cause then it looks very nasty, it looks muddy, and the quality doesn't retain compared to what we shot inside the studio. I'm very selective on the shots that I'm going for. So all I did really was use one light to light him up. And that was a Nanlite mixed panel 60. And I used the diffusion and the grid just to concentrate on them so it doesn't kind of like overpower like the side of the area where the bridge was at. I just wanted to keep it narrow on him. And we did change the actual temperature of the light. Instead of 5600, where it's daylight, I wanted it to match the actual light of the bridge. So I went down on and did like a little bit more of a tungsten look just to match it. And to be honest, it looks organic. It looks really good. And I will tell you guys to always try to make sure, try to give the image as more of an organic look as possible, because that looks the most cinematic. And for this particular scene, it just looks very crystal clear and it looks like those lights are powering him. But realistically, we had a mixed panel 60 and we had a V-mount powering it. That's the beautiful part about the Nanlite mixed panel 60 light. You can add any V-mount 14 volt battery. They're pretty cheap nowadays. I think you could get one for like 150 and it powers it up even at 100% for like about 2 hours, maybe even a little bit more, I'm not sure. Normally, I'm up and down with the power of the light. The Nanlite Mix Panel 60 was used for the outdoor scene, just one light. I had my friend basically holding it as I was pulling back with the gimbal. And also, as you guys saw, there was a jump cut. It was a wide shot and a tight shot. So another little tip is when you guys are shooting music videos, make sure you guys get a wide, get a close up. Don't get lazy and just get one shot and be done with, or get the same shot over and over again. Make sure you guys switch it up. So in case you want to cut in, you're able to do that. Sometimes it looks better closer with the depth of field. Really just, you know, get creative with it and get as much shots as you can. So now we're gonna start off with, we're inside the studio, and this is where we had the model, and she was kind of like depressed and kind of uncertain on whether, you know, she made the right decision on basically kicking him out and being done with the relationship. For this shot, notice how the back windows, they're blown out, right? And that's because the sun was harsh as hell and it was coming from that back end. So quick little tip that I'll tell you guys is don't try to overpower and try to expose for the outside if you guys can't do it. For this particular scene, the lights that I had was a Nanlite Mix Panel 60, the Nanlite Mix Panel 150, and the Nanlite Forza 300. And even if I went to expose her, it was not gonna be possible to compensate for the outside. So instead of trying to overpower it and just getting a little bit of the information outside the windows, I'll recommend just having a harsh lighting, like a glow coming from the windows, so it looks more cinematic than, you know, normally when you see like some of the window areas it's exposed and the other one's just blown out. That looks terrible. So try to keep it either blown out windows, or, you know, you're exposing the full outsides. That's really all I can tell you guys. And because the sun was coming from the back end, you know, as I was moving with the camera, I did see there was a ray coming in. So obviously the more I move, the more the ray would just come in, and her getting up, it would just introduce that. So little things like that, try to look for creative shots that enhance it, that you don't have to do an effect like that in post. I really like that shot. And for the greens, I wanted to do a little bit more moody green, so I kind of desaturated the greens a little bit and just try to give it a different tone. But yeah, I really exposed her. And for this scene right here, it was the Nanlite Forza 300 and the Mix Panel 150, if I'm correct. Those are the two lights that we used to expose this setup right here. Now, one thing that I'm trying to do better going forward on all my music videos is, number one is game planning, right? Trying to get shots that you can't do in editing. So, you know, something that I've known and I've always said is, you can give any editor you know, a video and they can create the same thing. If someone edits like this, some other editor can do the same thing. However, when it's grabbed on camera, like on set, you really can't replicate that. It has to be done on set. So I wanted to do a way where I can do a fluid transition. So for each particular scene in this music video, there was a before and there was an after. So basically, like, she's still thinking, she's uncertain, and then it goes into the, like, the plant, and then I masked it where now it's showing the good old times where, you know, they're having a great time, and she's, you know, basically reminiscing those moments. Anytime that you guys are shooting videos, try to make sure you guys try to get everything in camera, the effects in post, just they have to enhance the video. If not, try to get everything in camera. They look a lot better, it looks organic, and it's different. It can't be replicated unless you're shooting for it. So for this one, I kind of put myself in a test where I wanted to make sure I grab a plant, and for every scene, I put the plant in a certain spot, so when I'm panning around it, I can go ahead and mask it, and I'm able to get the separation and the differences from before when they were having a good time and the after when she's sad and stuff. So yeah, that's a quick little tip. Try to just do everything in camera if you guys can do that. So one thing that I also did for this particular music video was I didn't do too many performance clips. I wanted to keep it very minimal. I wanted to keep it more story oriented. I wanted to keep most of the performance in the bridge because he's leaving. So it's basically starting off and it's gonna, you know, just kind of go throughout the video. So I want to keep it very minimal. I knew in the studio I was gonna have him maybe perform once or twice, but I wanted to keep it, again, it's more story. So don't think you have to overshoot as far as performance. Kind of, again, walk in with a game plan where more B-roll is better than, you know, more performances at times. Really depends on the music you're going for. For this particular music video, it was more story driven, so I definitely wanted to capture a gang of B-roll, so I'm able to implement it over the song rather than having performances. And, you know, we see that a lot on rap and hip-hop videos, but for R&B, I feel like heavy B-roll for the most part helps tell the story. All right, so now what we did for this particular video was we obviously booked it, I think it was 5 p.m. to 10 p.m. or maybe it was 6 to 10. So the reason why I did that is because I wanted the sunset hour, basically. So we were gonna have like a 2 hour gap or 2 hours and a half with sun, and then I wanted the other half with no lighting. It was gonna be nighttime, so that way I'm able to overpower the inside and change the look, give it a different tone, And this is where this came in. So the first shot that we did was basically she was sitting in the table, grabbing the flowers, kind of, you know, the flowers never moved from the moment Chris Will threw those flowers at the beginning of the video. And now she's playing with them and she's kind of overthinking it. The way we lit it up was we used the Aperture MCs and we put them on the floor in the back end just to cause some tungsten look. And again, just give it a different tone, different mood, not keep it so flat. So that's what we did. And the light that we used was a mixed panel 150. That was the key light for this particular shot, and we did use a honeycomb grid to concentrate the light on her. And obviously I was moving from left to right to mask through the plant and then show the old school times. A little detail that I did was definitely try to get a close shot of the rose, because that's what she's playing in this wide shot. So kind of just make it go hand in hand when it's going back to the good old days and the rose was there when they were kind of making out on the tables. A little detail that I want to just kind of make sure it stays in there. So for this particular scene here, I had him looking forward and I had him in his own head, like never look at the camera. You're just explaining your inner, you know, feelings and what you want to spit out basically for the song. And the one thing people told me when I posted this on Instagram a long time ago was like, yo, like the colors are fire. Like, how did you get this? Like, how did you get out of the Panasonic S1H? Many people don't tend to realize is I don't just color grade in Premiere and that's pretty much it. The way I go about it is I make sure I light up to basically give me a solid head start. So when I go into color grading, I'm able to manipulate the image a lot more. I separate my subject from the foreground, from the background, whatever the case is. So it's easier for me to color grade and get the tones that I want. So for this one, it was very easy, right? I knew the walls were white, so I wanted to give it more of a bluer tone. I knew his skin tone was gonna pop. I also knew the green leaves, you know, the way everything was touched. I look at everything when I'm filming on set. I recommend for you guys to do it as well, just so you guys can see, you know, pinpoint, all right, what is separated what, how can I change the tone? What kind of mood you wanna give the video? Lighting plays a big factor when it comes to setting the tone, the color grading. So that's a quick tip. Make sure you guys light for the color grading. It can't just be color graded and that's it, unless shooting outdoors. But in a studio, if you want those crispy separation shots, lighting's gonna help you do that. And now the last shot that I wanna break down is the shot that you'll see towards the end of the video is where he's performing and I was just basically orbiting around the plant. I didn't do masking on this. This is more of just creating a foreground. The lighting setup that we did here was a Nanlite Forza 300B and we had it on tungsten mode. And then we had little Aperture MCs and they're magnetic. So if you guys watch in the back end of him, there's magnets. It's like a magnet like plate or so. And I was able to just mount three of them there and they look organic. It doesn't look like, you know, we placed it there. It looks like those lights are just there. So I will only show the lights if it's meant to, you know, enhance the video. It's not just there just to be there. Felt like that was cool and it gave him backlight. So it separated him as well. That's why I booked the studio daytime towards sunset and then nighttime, because nighttime is gonna allow me to get these type of tones. You're gonna be able to see the lights, because if I booked this all in daytime, the outside sun was gonna overpower every light that I was using for this particular scene. So I had that in mind and that's how I'm able to like get the tones that I want. It's basically having full control of lighting. So that's a tip. Make sure you guys always know the time you guys are shooting. Make sure if you guys want two different scenes within that studio and but they have big windows, book it like towards sunset time. So then it translates into nighttime and you're able to get two different looks. And that's why we shot everything, to be honest, in one location. The second location, the only location we did separate was when he was walking in the bridge, but everything else was done in this studio. There's a lot of music videos you can do in one studio. It just comes down to creativity, switching your angles, giving different shots, get as much as you can in different type of views so people don't get bored than, you know, shooting, let's say me right now, just the whole time there's like different scenes within this area, it'll just bore it out. What I normally do for my videos is I make sure there's new shots coming in throughout the whole music video. I never like to showcase everything in the first minute and a half. I like to, for the most part, separate my video clips so that way it's different and people are able to watch the whole video than basically show them everything in the first minute. So a tip that I want to tell you guys there is make sure you guys separate your shots or shoot, you know, the full performances in every location that you shoot in. But make sure when you're editing, you're separating the first half and the second half. And well, towards the end, you can obviously bring every clip back, but just try to separate it. It looks a lot better and it keeps the viewers engaged. So overall, really what I want to just, why I did this video, this breakdown, is just to give you guys the, I guess, the gear that I use as far as audio. People talked about that, which is a Tascam DR10. The lighting was all lit with Nanlite. The only apertures I used was the small little MCs. The clutch thing about those little lights, I have the 12 case kit for it. With the phone, you can just go to the Sidus Link app and literally just control all the lights. And it's really easy to use when you're behind camera. Just control the intensity of it and then just keep it where you want it. And that's it. So yeah, hopefully this video helps you guys. Maybe the tips and advice that I talked to you guys on, you know, can help you guys on, you know, getting better music videos or creating better music videos. I'm really satisfied with this video. I feel like when me and Chris get together, We bounce ideas, and realistically, you know, we always have a game plan. He normally gives me the song a month prior, so come shoot day, we already know what we're going for, and that's what this video basically was about. So you guys were even able to see the story, right? If you guys have not watched this video, feel free to do so. I'll be linking the description below, and also I'll have it somewhere here in case you guys are interested on that. And I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out, guys.
What's up, babe?
Don't even touch me.
What are you tripping for? What's wrong?
What's wrong?
Yeah.
You never had time for me. Never.
You know what I'm doing. It's not like I'm out here cheating or running around. It's about
tired.
The music.
Yes, it is.
What's
wrong? It is. You don't have time for me. I'm tired.
I don't have time for you.
No.
You know that I'm close. Look where we live.
Yeah, but I think that you can find more time for me. It's not
but
that hard.
I told you this is temporary. I'm doing this for us.
No, you're not. It's just for you. It's always about you. It's been 1 year. You already say that many times.
But I'm serious this time. I'm close.
Oh, this time, yes.
Yes.
And the other time? And the time before?
Babe.
You gotta no. Trust. It's no more babe.
It's no more babe.
No.
Happy anniversary.